Lurching closer toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. No run back here on the opening kickoff as we'll start at the 25. Second down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over at that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
But when you're going up against a talented receiver like that, you just know that they're going to bring more people to him, right? They've got a double cover every chance they get.
I think that that is what we're going to see all game long, an early taste of that double, maybe even sometimes triple coverage we might see.
Yeah, I think what they're counting on, his talent to sometimes beat that double coverage.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A big play that time on the catch and run. 32 yards. On first and 10, it's Swift. And that one opened up for him well as he'll take this down to the 26-yard line.
Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Hurts sets up to throw it. Quick slant here to Smith. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20. First and goal. A chance for an early statement here on the road. Here's Swift. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. DeAndre Swift, his second rushing touchdown on the year. And the Eagles will jump on top with the game's first score here this afternoon.
Extra point splits the uprights, and it's now a 7-0 game. The Eagle kick team out there now as they run up and send this one away.
Now this is going to be returned from the back.
And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football.
Oh, and one of the linebackers has got it.
So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy, because you want to make sure that the catch is secured. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
They throw right away. That's complete out on the right side. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. That'll wind up a gain of 27 on the catch and run. Just the first quarter of attack, then, going to be so important going forward. They've got to limit plays like that.
And that's something when you see it happen early in the game and they don't get him on the ground, you can always tell that they were concerned about it going in. Because I can just tell you, from my days, I remember being in college and worrying all offseason about our season open opponent, and they had a receiver that could shake and bake with the best of them. I tackled him on the first pass of the game, and the relief was incredible. I ended up having a pretty decent ball game. But if I had missed him, it would have been a
story.
Long night.
And he'll get two, maybe three, up near the 37.
You look at this Eagle defense.
This unit, they're hoping to improve against the pass, because right now Charles is number 27 in the NFL.
What they lack in pass defense, they do make up for in run defense. They're a top 10 unit against some people trying to move the ball on the ground. But this is a passing league, so there's a conundrum for them. How do they get better defending the pass?
Here comes third down at 7.
In motion comes the tight end left. On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to wind up and air it out. Got a man that's caught at the 6-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
It's early, but announcer cliche alert here. Big players make big plays. Should I say in big games, too? Oh, what the heck. And this defense, they're going to have to find some way to slow him down as this game goes on, because when this combination is going good, they can tear your secondary apart.
And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
Corners are known for their ability to cover, but those that'll stick their nose in against the running game, that's a bonus for any team. And what a nice play right there, tackling him for a loss.
Back at the 5-yard line now, second and goal. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he'll take this into the end zone for a San Francisco touchdown. A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Niners respond to that opening drive touchdown with one of their own. Moody good with the extra point, and we are tied at 7. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. From the end zone, here comes Williams. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they have the game here followed by the open date on their calendar next weekend. And Charles, this is a crew that you have to think really is relishing the opportunity to be on the couch for a few days.
Yeah, they certainly are. But let's face it, partner, they can't get caught looking ahead to that couch time while they're playing this one. They've got to take care of business first.
Here's a 2nd and 5 now from the 25. Throwing is Hurts. And that is incomplete. Nearly intercepted. The free safety couldn't quite get his hands around it, and it brings up 3rd down. They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. Hurts. Able to hook up with Williams here on the out route. And I don't think he got there, no. He's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it 4th and inches.
Well, we hear so often how tackling has become almost a lost art in the NFL game. But it's so important to tackle well on these receivers, especially in a play like this one. 3rd down, they gave him the underneath stuff. You got to go up and make the tackle right away.
A penalty accepted, and they move the ball forward. They've got good starting field position as they come up here 1st and 10 at the 40. They'll drop to throw. Pressure comes, and down he goes. The Eagles get there for the sack. That's big Jordan Davis powering in to drop him.
Well, that's an excellent way to get the pass rush activated. The first sack of the game for them comes on the first play of the drive, and it makes it very tough for the opponent to pick up a 1st down now, playing behind the sticks.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw, escaping the pressure right. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's 3rd down.
And this drive is almost over before it began, thanks to a great defensive effort. Sack on 1st down, followed by an incompletion. One more good rep, and they get off the field.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Looking to throw. He'll fire this deep for Ayuk. And that's caught inside the 30. And he will work his way out of bounds here at the 25-yard line. A big third down play there for the Niners. 45 yards. Pretty good timing. He waited just enough for that post play to develop and laid it right in there.
And you know what a lot of teams do when they decide to throw a post route? Because it's a little bit longer developing play. And max protect. Bring everyone in, keep the tight end in, and extra back to make sure the quarterback has time to deliver the football.
The Niners have 1-6 now. But Charles, they were losers last time out. What do you think they need to do differently here?
Well, I don't think it needs to be as drastic as burning up last week's game tape or not watching it, but the attitude has to be what's done is done. Let's move on. Put that one behind them, galvanize themselves, and go forward and get a win in this one.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. The safety, Terrell Edmonds, picks it. And the Eagles are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. And this, Charles, definitely not what they were wanting to see. Remember, he threw three interceptions in the loss last week, and now he gives the ball away again here in the very first quarter.
And you have to think that this was drilled into him all week, too, by his teammates, by his coaching staff. They've told him all week long, we've got to protect the football. They probably crossed that fine line with giving him the right advice and saying it too much, and it turned out that it got into his head a little bit.
Line of scrimmage, the 28 now, as they come up on second and a couple. Here's Hurts to throw. Wide open is Watkins. He's got it. Down the right sideline. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Quez Watkins. 72 yards, and the Eagles have taken the lead. Point after, right down the middle, and that makes the score 14-7. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes and get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
The rush defense stout on first down. Here's second and 10 from the 20. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. That's caught inside the 20. A big play there for the Niners. 62 yards. And we're pointing out, after that last completion, that puts this young quarterback over 10,000 yards passing for his career. And fair to say, he's not done yet.
No doubt about it. He's really just getting started because he's not quite into the prime of his career. So it's likely he's going to hit a few more of these milestones as this career progresses. makes it. We'll acknowledge this number, and we'll celebrate the milestones down the road.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on second and 14. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. That is caught by the tight end, Kittle. Touchdown, 49ers. From 21 yards away. And the Niners are an extra point away from drawing level. Now Moody for the PAT. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And Williams going to sit on this one. It'll be a touchback. At their own 25-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Well, partner, fast forward with me for a second. Remember, next week they have the open week, so they're going to get some extended rest. Does that change how they manage the rest of this one?
I think it does a little bit, but not by too much, because you're right. You get the extra rest, you get a chance to heal up and kind of, you know, do a little bit of a reset for this team. But it's also 7 extra days to think back to the last time you were on the field. So now, a little more importance on what they're getting done, because they carry it with them for essentially 2.
Second and 6, just inside the 30. Now back to throw. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. 6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down.
That's a pretty play there coming out of the backfield. But as that back, you've got to be conscious of making sure you're securing the football. When you get out in open field, sometimes you get a little loose with it as you're trying to get up ahead of steam. Make sure you keep it close to your body, because those defenders are trying to punch it free. He does a nice job there protecting the ball and picking up a first down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Play action. Here's Hurts. And that's going to be incomplete.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
Second down. Here's Hurts. Throw left sideline, falls incomplete.
The coverage was good, but I just wonder if they absolutely fooled the quarterback on that play. I think he was expecting something else. Ended up with nowhere to throw the football successfully.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. He's got his target. That's complete. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 39. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. They will run straight ahead with Swift. And he maneuvers up the middle for three. And it's second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Second and seven. He'll look to throw. Over the middle here to Brown. It'll be a gain of five, and it makes it third down and 2 yards to go.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he get a good head of steam going.
The Eagles on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. Here it's third and two. They'll try and run here with Swift. A great effort there to shed the contact, and it helps him pick up the first. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. Got a man, it's Brown. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. The catch and run there, good for 16 and a first.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
And boy, showing how tough he can be to bring down, just fighting his way forward to pick up 7 yards.
Some good strong running right there. Some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
Right back to Swift again on second down. And he will take this one in for an Eagle touchdown. DeAndre Swift with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Eagles have moved out in front. And the kick makes it through, but flags come flying in as well. It appears we're going to get a roughing call tacked on. And that flag accepted. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. They'll try and start this drive in the air. This one caught by Kittle. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pickup there, a 22.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. Oh, and his early struggles continue. Here's another one intercepted. Isaiah Simmons picking it off. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD. Now for the point after. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And this is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Charles, you're down multiple scores, less than a minute left here, but with that deficit, they've got to try to at least work their way into field goal range to try to muster something out of this drive.
And I'm going to go ahead and date myself.
He's got it at the 15. Touchdown! Good with the extra point. And they're within seven now at 28-21. So following the touchdown, here's Moody back out to send it away. And Williams going to sit on this one. It'll be a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. They'll come up now second and four from the 31. Back to throw. Eluding the pressure right. This will be caught by Brown. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. On first and 10, it's Hurts. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line.
So the first thing that crossed my mind is, why didn't they just sit on the lead and take it to the locker room? They're in good shape.
Absolutely. And from this spot on the field, now you've given the other side a chance for points here going into intermission.
Yeah, you changed the momentum of the game, and it's something you did not need to do.
Now a first down run is going nowhere. He's going to be dropped in the backfield, a loss of two. Now a timeout called for by the offense as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half. So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. They'll look to throw here. And that one off the mark behind him, incomplete. The turnover put him in great field position. They don't want to squander it with third down coming up.
No, not at all. And you know what else you do? You make your defense mad.
Yeah.
They got you the football, gave you a great opportunity. You got to cash in and get some points.
They'll set up a throw. Oh, he'll look downfield for Kittle. And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that. Well, that would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
And that is not what you expect from a receiver of his caliber. Sometimes you get a little ahead of yourself. You don't look it in, and all of a sudden it's on the ground. A surprise to all.
Wisnowski on to punt as he sends this one away. So a change of possession here on the punt. And control of the football switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
But first down, Hurts. Forced out to his left. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? Here comes the return from the very back of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. This offense, Charles, had a strong first half throwing the football, at least in terms of yardage, but that hasn't translated so far on the scoreboard. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. And they will finally stop him as he's down to the 40-yard line. That one is going to sting. First play of the third quarter and a turnover.
And you have to know that at halftime, they spent a lot of time going through their checklist of what they wanted to accomplish to start this third quarter. Turning it over like this was not on that list.
Not at all. You come out of the locker room trailing, so that first drive to establish momentum is very key.
Crucial.
The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. Kenny Clark, the big D tackle there to make the stop.
Early down stuffs have put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
And when you're in a one-score game in the second half, now's not the time to force the football to places where you shouldn't. And that's a smart decision to just get that one out of there.
On third down, here comes Swift. And they'll get to him short of the first down at about the 16. It'll be a gain of four, but it won't be enough. It leaves him with a fourth down now. His kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. Whatever was said in the locker room during the break must have worked. They forced the turnover. They didn't get the touchdown, Charles, but it does translate into 3 points to begin this second half.
Exactly as they discussed in the locker room at halftime, get some points to get things kick-started. Now start your half off with some momentum. Gives you something to build on for your next possession.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all of our friends who play fantasy.
It's caught inside the 25. A big play there for the Niners. 57 yards.
Well, he already had a big receiving game working. And it's going to get a lot better here. Defensively, they're fortunate. This is not a touchdown. But he's just been absolutely unstoppable. And he comes up with yet another gigantic play.
Yeah, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Now a second and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. Back to throw here. Oh, he had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
Certainly looked like someone was very confident in his ability to fit that one in. I would say he was overconfident because there wasn't a whole lot of separation there. Had that one covered pretty well downfield and knocked it away.
And his kick is indeed good. And this is back down to a seven-point game. So give him three on that drive. And, you know, normally you'd say, we'll take it. But the way points have been flying around, it feels like a little bit of a letdown.
Yeah, you just have to wonder, are field goals going to be enough? Because as you pointed out, the way touchdowns have been scored, does kicking a field goal actually put you at a disadvantage the rest of the way?
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
Throwing is Hurts. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Well, he certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
They run out of the gun with Swift. There he goes, left side. DeAndre Swift. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. So following the holding call, what can they do here on third and long? Hurts. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10.
Here we go.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
On play action, they'll throw. And this one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football. Nearly a fourth pick of the ball game. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Pass taken in by his big tight they get the conversion on 3rd and 13.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them, and these guys have been taking advantage so far.
They go play action here on 1st down. He's across midfield, and he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice 1st down. Drive keeps moving.
Back to throw again. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived. And I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Multiple defenders getting to him there for a huge loss.
Now that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense, so he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
7th play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on 3rd down. Oh, he's got him in wide open, complete. A crazy sequence here. A huge gain that time, but it still leaves him well short for 4th down.
With that last completion, CD's now over 400 yards passing in the game, and quite a few of those have come via some pretty big strikes downfield. Certainly not afraid to challenge this secondary, and it's been successful.
I like your observation there, partner, because I agree. This is a group more than capable of torching a secondary any week, as evidenced by their combined stat line here. And in the time we have remaining, wouldn't shock me at all to see them take another deep shot.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go.
These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
From the 48-yard line, here's 2nd down and 7.
Hurts sets up to throw it. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far and brings up 3rd down. Swift going to try up the middle. And they nearly sprung him that time as he takes this all the way down to the 37. 106 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. 1st down, Eagle. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Brown. Takes this to the 32, maybe the 31, and then the defense rallying quickly after that broken tackle.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route, and what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
7 yards there and a 1st down.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front 7, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
Now a throw here, hauled in. A gain of 8 there on the play. And they'll be left with 2nd and a couple.
And we've seen him have success earlier on with the ball in his hands because he is a get it in space and make a play kind of a receiver. But that time, they closed on him quickly and held him to a short game.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. Now they face a 2nd and long following the holding penalty. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Flushed out right, and he'll slide to a halt here, still a level shy of the first down marker. He turned that into a nice gain, gets him 8 yards closer for 3rd down.
I like how he hung in there and went through his progressions, but eventually his internal clock went off and told him it was time to make a run for it, and he ends up sliding down with a solid gain.
And this won't be enough. Stopped a yard short after a gain of 3, 4th down.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive could take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
And this one is right through, and that will extend their lead even further. So that's, CD, an important one here in the 4th quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. All eyes on both sidelines were staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a 2-score game.
Step down the numbers. There he goes. Still going past the 30. And he'll bring it back all the way. Touchdown, 49ers. And that big 4th quarter return, Charles, makes this a 1-score game.
And now it all comes down to philosophy. All right, they just had the big return for a touchdown, so the momentum is high. Do you want to ride that and go for 2? Or do you just go ahead and kick the extra point and come back and rely on your defense?
And it's no good. Well, that could be a critical miss here in a 1-score game in the 4th. So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. Fair catch going to be taken, and this will be moved out to the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a 1-score game. And you hear a lot about 2-minute offense and 4-minute offense. Obviously, the 4-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the 4-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
They try to throw on 2nd down, but this one is incomplete.
He's just not at his focus in this game. It's not 1 drive. It's not 2. That's 3 for this contest.
Yeah, uncharacteristic for any NFL receiver, and he's no exception. From the gun, here's Swift. Trying to barrel up in there, but I don't think he got it. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a 4th down. That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture. quarterback that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage, but you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. From the gun, it's Hurts. And this one is incomplete. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth. And the Niners take over in terrific field position. So that's a decision that could loom pretty large here. They go for it on fourth down, but come up empty.
But I actually like the call, and the reason? It shows me a head coach has faith in his team overall. First on the offensive side, thinking they can pick it up, but also knowing that he has faith in his defense that if they don't, they'll go out there and stop him. I like the confidence he showed.
A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they threw it. Now with a short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And that is incomplete.
Well, how about the coverage we just saw break out on third down? Dime defense, blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed. Unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
Who wants it more? This is fourth and a yard. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. That's to his running back, complete. And he is going to have a 49ers first down. Well, they take a chance there on fourth and one, but it's a gain of three and a new set of downs. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. Plenty of time. All three timeouts still remain. Here's first and 10 now. A strong broken tackle on that one. And then they get him to the ground just shy of the 15.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Here's second down and three. They'll keep it on the ground. Winters, and this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two, third and one. Now a timeout called for by the defense as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Boy, here's a big one. You can just feel it. This is third down now. They'll try the left side. Winters, and he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And Charles, you look at this offense, their struggles moving the ball well documented. Dead last in the NFL in first downs, but signs of life there.
Yeah, and you and I do, I think, a really good job of respecting the game and respecting the teams. But this squad, they're in a position now where their fan base gets excited when they pick up a first down. They cheer almost like they picked up a touchdown.
All three timeouts still at their disposal. Here's first and 10 now.
He'll look to throw. Rolling to his left. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down.
More than one defender there, and that's a loss of five on the sack.
Brandon, that's just football 101. If you're out of the pocket, you've got to get rid of the football in this situation. You cannot take a sack in a two-minute drill.
Back to throw. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his home. Got to totally command and make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
A big play needed, no doubt. Third and long.
Back to throw. That is caught inside the five. And out of bounds all the way down at the three.
Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
The decision made for him. They've got to go. It's fourth down.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Able to find the open man. That's complete. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds left to play. Fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They felt compelled to go for it, and they got it.
Well, I looked down at my play sheet, and what I would find, plays that have been successful throughout the game that have worked in the distance you need, and that's exactly what they got done.
Here's first and goal.
They'll look to throw. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And with inside of 10 seconds, 8 to be precise, we get whistles and a timeout on the field.
It looked like the defense, they were ready for that one.
Really left him almost no room to work after catching the ball. He could throw every move in the book at him. They were there, and they tackle him for a loss.
Now they'll pitch it out here. And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line. And now the Niners going to signal for their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. One final shot. They'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And is it a touchdown? No signal. No. They say incomplete.
Well, this ball game was close throughout. Remember, it was neck and neck at intermission, neck and neck at the end, but a great job to come in here in a tough environment, Charles, and get the victory.
Yeah, tough environment indeed. How about all the people we can hear shouting from their seats right below us, partner? They weren't real happy that their team didn't keep the home field. How about...
Thank you. Say you gon' ride, say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide, say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step by me? Who gon' step by me?
Yeah, told him I would be a boss before I had business. I don't even need nobody here to vouch. I was all alone, so I ain't have a witness. Right back to the lab. Gotta go to work, I'm revving up my engine. I was just putting groceries in the bag. Now wait a minute, yeah, forgot to mention. I'm $100 million richer. Might paint $100 million picture. One man army, but I don't fatigue. Better have $100 million coming with you. Got good karma, so I'm riding fiscal. Hit the crossover, leave them playing Twister. Or they thought that I was just a... Now when I'm through, they call me mister. Stop it. Big wall will suffice. Play with the family, playing with your life. Just got the ops hurt, looking sick. So we gon' disinfect them like a wipe. Had that boy a big cat with no stripes. Now on the gram, ain't worried about a light. Yeah, I had to go ahead and raise the fee. If you ain't rocking with it, take a hike.
Say you gon' ride. Say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide. Say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step by me? Who gon' step by me? Say you gon' ride. Is he gon' step by me? Can't do it back, keep racks on me. Name him with, I keep three on me. Oh, so you ride it. I can do everything that you gon' like. Young, rich, and famous, I'm living the life. Uh-oh, pull up in that new thing. I'm swerving and hogging up both lanes. You know I'm in the mood. After I score, I'ma bring it to you. They're a free agent, I give them the boo. I'm with the crew who we bringing it to. We got no limit, yeah, we on the ride. We all gon' step, we all gon' ride. Say you gon' ride. Say you gon' step by me, spin the slide. Say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step by me? Who gon' step by me?
Every time I'ma step with the steppers, black and white bins looking like pepper. Flawless diamonds, yeah, I'm good under pressure. 400 racks tucked in the dresser. Blowing money fast like Big Meech. Thinking that they winning, big reach. They know I'm the best, I'm elite. I know when they hating is instant.
Say you gon' ride, say you gon' step by me. Spin the slide, say you gon' step by me. Who gon' step by me? Who gon' step by me?
So she leave her best friends. Bust out my dad face. Your chain is a neck.
I'm block over short. I'm popping down Miami Beach. Pull up like LeBron with the heat. Huh. I bought a crib in the crib with the office. Shit, bitch, at my mom, but I can't see me walking there. I whip a Tesla, but it ain't no charge of that. I call up Cohen Brianna, been parking the top box seats. I'm watching Archer, that cop like stop right next to my block and trust me. Beat, I might drop that hips on the stallion and Doja her top half. Huh. 2300 on the horse and I'm Mike. Switching out the character, the strip is like tight. Legends on 3, 2, 1.
Oh, you tried it. You say you love me like you love him, you lying. You know your worth for what it's worth, I could buy it. We'll say it's only at the top, but I'm biased. Because I'm only at the top, but you tried it. You say you love me like you love him, you lying. You know your worth for what it's worth, I could buy it. We'll say it's only at the top, but I'm biased.
Got it, please don't got it, with me. Left wrist got it, right wrist got it, neck is got it. just go that, just go that, 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 me, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Don't get the dark, cause the feds on it.
Sometimes they call me Lucifer. Talk about you do this and that. Ain't none of that that new to us. Acting like that you popped off. No damn well that you grew to us. Been in my own lane. Carry you like that dude the truck. Trend following. I'm surprised you just now catching up. It's my way or the highway, baby. Girl, I'm not a settler. Don't play with my kind. I'm out of my mind. I promise.